Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. Let everything that have breath praise the Lord. The Lord is good. His mercy is everlasting, and his truth endures to all generations. Come on, I know it's been 5 months, but here we are. Hallelujah, somebody. Here we are. Hallelujah, on this second Sunday of August, gathered together to praise the Lord. Come on, praise the Lord, everybody. Come on, come on. Go ahead, clap those hands. Come on, come on. Lift your hands. Clap your hands. Raise your voices. I know you got your mask on, but guess what? It don't shut your mouth. You ought to come on and give God some praise. Hallelujah. 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 Come on, it's the highest praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Shout with the voice of triumph. Come on, lift your voice and tell the Lord, thank you today. Thank him for his goodness. Thank him for his mercy. Thank him for, come on, he kept you through this pandemic. Come on, it's still going on. But you ought to give God praise anyhow. Come on, if you know he's worthy to be praised, you ought to lift up your voices. Lift up a shout of praise unto God, because God has been good to you. Come on. You ain't got to worry about what he's been good to somebody else, but you ought to be thankful that he's been good to you. Come on. If you know he's been good to you, you ought to lift them up and give him glory today. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. There ought to be a sound in this parking lot. There ought to be a sound in the atmosphere. Hallelujah. 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 Bless that wonderful name of Jesus. Bless that wonderful name of Jesus. Oh, bless that wonderful name of Jesus. There is no... Come on, I want to hear you today. Oh, we come to bless that wonderful name of... I can't hear you. Bless that wonderful name of... That's better. Come on. Hey, bless that wonderful name of Jesus. There is no other name. There's power in the name of Jesus. Power in the name of Jesus. Oh, power in the name of... There is power in the name of Jesus. There is no other name. Oh, there is love in the name of. Oh, love in the name of. There is love in the name of Jesus. There is no other name. Deliverance in the name. Deliverance in the name of. In the name of Jesus, there's deliverance in the name of. There is no other name of salvation. Salvation in the name of. There's salvation in the name of. Oh, salvation in the name of. There is no other name I know. Jesus, I'll never forget what you done for me. Jesus, I'll never forget how you set me free. Oh, Jesus, I'll never forget how you brought me out. Oh, Jesus, I'll never forget. No, never. Come on, Jesus, I'll never forget what you done for me. Jesus, I'll never forget how you said. Jesus, I'll never forget how you brought me out. Jesus, I'll never forget, no, never. How can I forget what you done for me? Oh, how can I forget how you set me free? Oh, how can I forget how you brought me out? Oh, how can I forget, no, never. Oh, Jesus, I'll never forget what you done. Oh, come on, come on, come on. Jesus, I'll never forget how you said. Oh, yes, Lord. Jesus, I'll never forget how you brought me out. Jesus, I'll never forget. Oh, how can I forget what you done for me? Come on here.
How can I forget how you set me free? How can I forget how you brought? Oh, how can I forget? No, never. Oh, Jesus, I'll never forget what you done. Come on, if that's your testimony, come on, sing it with us today. How you set me free. Oh, Jesus, I'll never forget how you brought. Come on, clap your hands, clap your hands. Come on, I can't hear your claps. Come on. Oh, yeah. Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo. Oh, Lord Jesus, I'll never forget how much you've done for me. Jesus, I'll never forget how you set me free. Jesus, I'll never forget how you brought me out. Jesus, I'll never forget. No, never. Now, come on, if you'll never forget what the Lord's done for you, come on, put your hands together, give God some praise. Come on Facebook land, give him some praise. Come on, give him some likes, give him some hearts, give him some praise. Hallelujah. Come on, are you excited to be out in the presence of the Lord today? Hallelujah. Let me hear you shout hallelujah. Let me hear you shout hallelujah. Oh, yeah. Woo. Hallelujah. Oh, y'all can't tell I'm excited. Y'all can't tell I'm excited. Amen. Amen. We're going to call now at this time. If you know the Lord has been good to you. Anybody know the Lord's been good to you? All right, if you know he's been good to you, we're going to give you an opportunity to tell just how good he's been to you. Come on here. We're going to open up the floor for testimony time for three individuals. Three individuals. And if you want to testify of the goodness of the Lord, won't you come on around here to the side to my left. And then one at a time, we're going to talk about the goodness of the Lord. Can we get three? Oh, I see one person running up here. Come on. Come on, one person is running to talk about the goodness of the Lord. And if that's you, if you want to talk about, if God's been good, he ain't been good to you. Has he been good to you? Oh, come on, if you're going to testify, I need you to come on up here. Don't play with me now. Hallelujah. Come on up. Here we go. We got two people. All right, we got two. We need one more, and then we're gonna go on. We need one more. If he's been good to you, come on, through COVID situations, through quarantine situations, come on. Come on, bills due situations. Come on, no money in the bank. He's been good. Y'all not going to talk to me today. Hallelujah. Oh, I'm on fire. I feel like praising him today. Come on, it's been 5 months. Listen, maybe it ain't pent up in you, but it's pent up in me. Huh? Come on, I want to let it out. Is that all right? Hallelujah. Woo! All right, we got our three. Here we go. Three persons.
Giving honor to God first, who's the head of my life. Hey, giving honor to Pastor Daniels and all those who are on the ministerial staff and the body of Christ. Hey, First Baptist.
Hallelujah.
Hey, my testimony. God has seen me through dangers seen and unseen. Hey, I'm still able to stand through three COVID tests locked in. COVID test negative. Then he allowed for me to send my son on to be with the Lord. And I'm still standing, y'all. Hey, bills been due. Money been short. But God has truly continually been faithful in my life. Hey, he's so faithful. He's so good and so great. I feel like a David when he fought the Philistine, the big old giant Goliath, right? But he said, all he had was a slingshot and a rock. But that wasn't it. He said he conferred with God first. So in my walk, through all these trials and tests, I had to confer with the Lord on my side. Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Woo. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Oh, yes. Oh, praise his name.
Back in March,
of this year, on the 15th of March, I went over to the VA hospital for a checkup. And when I got there, they tested my temperature and all that, and they took me upstairs, put me in the hospital. And when I found out anything, they told me I had the virus. So I was there for about 4 or 5 days, and this is just my opinion that they said, well, at my age, you know, they just sent me home. So that's what they did. They sent me home. And 2 days later, I got a call from the CDC, and they verified that I did have the virus, and they asked me different questions. And right then, I mean, that's a heck of a thing to hear. But right after I got off the phone, I started praying to Jesus. Yeah. Yeah. And since then, I'm clean. Yeah. Okay. So I can verify what God can do. Oh, yeah. See, God can do whatever he want to do when he want to do it. Thank you.
Amen. Amen. Come on. Yes, sir.
All right. Amen. Excuse me. If I can get anything out, I'm kind of...
We hear you, Doc. We hear you real
good. If I make this real short... No, I was listening to a song this morning, and it said, after all that I've been through, I'm still standing.
Come on.
God is blessing me right now. He woke me up this morning, and he started me on my way. God, keep on blessing me over and over again.
Over and over.
Amen.
Amen. Here we go. Here we go. All right. All right. Amen. Amen. Thank you. All right. Amen. Thank God for these three powerful testimonies. Come on, let's give God praise for these three individuals. Testify to the goodness of the Lord. Amen. At this time, we're gonna go right into our congregational song. And I want you guys, come on and stand with us. And let's sing together a testimony that we all have. That can't nobody do me like Jesus. Oh, is that your testimony today? I don't know about you, but can't nobody do me like Jesus. Can't nobody love me like Jesus. Can't nobody hug me like Jesus. Can't nobody hold me like Jesus. Can't nobody do me like Jesus. Come on, can't nobody do me like Jesus. Can't nobody do me like the, oh, can't nobody do me like, oh, he's my, oh, can't nobody, I can't hear you. Oh, do me like, oh, can't nobody do me like, oh, he's my, pick me up and turn me, pick me up and he, turn me around, pick me up and he, turn me, oh, he pick me up and he, turn me around, he's my. Heal my body told me, heal my body told me to run on. Oh, he healed my body and told me. Oh, he healed my body and told me. Oh, he's. Come on, y'all ought to say that again. He healed my body and he told me. Even when you felt like you felt good, he healed your body, huh? And told me. Oh, he healed my body and told me, oh, he's my. Oh, can't nobody do me like Jesus. Oh, can't nobody do me like Jesus. Oh, kick me up and turn me around. Oh, pick me up and turn me around. Oh, hear my body told me to run on. Oh, hear my body told me to run on. Oh, nobody. Oh, nobody. Oh, nobody. Oh, nobody. Oh, can't nobody do me like Jesus. Oh, can't nobody do me like Jesus. Oh, he's my friend. Oh, yeah. Oh, he's my friend. Oh, yeah, yeah. He's my friend. Come on, put your hands together. Come on, clap your hands. Come on, clap your hands. Nobody do me like Jesus. Oh, can't nobody do me like Jesus. Come on, it's been 5 months. Can't nobody do me like Jesus. Hey, can't nobody do me like Jesus. Hey, nobody. Oh, nobody. He's my friend. Woo! He's my friend. Come on, give him glory today. Hallelujah. Woo! Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Yay, hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah here. Amen. Amen. Anybody know that can't nobody do you like Jesus? Woo! I'm a witness. Can't nobody do me like Jesus. Nobody. Not my mama. Not my father. Not my so-called friend. Oh, y'all not going to say nothing to me. Can't nobody. All right, that's enough. Hallelujah. Amen. Where did Pastor Daniels go? Amen. Hallelujah. Can't nobody do me like Jesus. Hallelujah. Come on. You can recall the role on your own family. Come on now. He's been good to your family. Come on. He didn't just start being good. He's been good. Woo! All of your life. Come on, Pastor Daniels. All right. Where did wipe go? Oh, here. Never mind. We got something here. Here we go.
Angie, Sister Morris, where's the war? But first of all, let me say praise the Lord. Let me say praise the Lord. Our God is an awesome God. Yeah, for 5 months we were self-contained, and the Lord blessed us to come out today and worship Him in open air. This is familiar to our great-great-grandparents. They did not have church buildings, but what they would do after they left the slave quarters working, they would go down to a hedge, and then they would get on their knees and pray, and they call on the name of God. And I'm so grateful that God does not require us to be in a building to be able to praise His name. The Word of God says, let everything that hath breath praise the Lord. Wherever you go, have thanksgiving in your hearts and praises upon your lips, and to God be the glory. Hallelujah. Just one sad note I would like to announce. Dr. Eugene Simmons lost his mother today, so we would definitely be praying for the Simmons family and all others who have lost loved ones. But let me say this. In 2020, this church family was affected with over 18 families with coronavirus. Over 18 families. And I have you to know that God brought every last one of them through. That's worth their praise. Only God could do that. Yeah. And you heard Brother Sears up in his 80s, but God brought him through. What a mighty God we serve. What a faithful God we serve. Hallelujah. Now, brothers and sisters, it's just good to be here. Today is your birthday. Did you know that? You should be excited about a birthday. God has allowed us to exist for 76 years. 76 years. Yes, we've had some ups and downs, but we're still here. And so we want to give him the praise. Annually, several years ago, one of the prominent, faithful, and dedicated members of First Baptist Congregational Church, in the person of the late Dr. Eddie Walker, a wonderful steward of the church. And we thought it would be fitting to annually award a plaque to those persons who have contributed likewise. So our recipient today is First Baptist takes great pleasure in honoring Reverend Cliff Williams as a recipient of this Dr. Eddie Walker Stewardship Award for many years of dedication, faithfulness, and service to our Lord. Awarded on this day of August in the year of our Lord, 2020, First Baptist Congregational Church, 76-year anniversary, Reverend George W. Daniels, Sr., Pastor. You need to hold this plaque up so they get a shot of it. Yeah, put it down in front of you. Hold it right. So they need to get a shot of it. Okay? And not only that, Reverend, we're not just giving you the plaque, but we're giving you a little token. Okay, here, you guys. Yeah, you can go out. You can go to McDonald's and Burger King. Go on. Help yourself. So let me just say we thank God for Pastor Williams. He's a wonderful person, and he's a missionary with his heart. And those who don't know it, he's a miracle. He and his wife that was stuck in Ghana with no way out. But the Lord opened up the sea and brought him home. He was calling me, and I said, Reverend, it's going to be all right. And then it cost him several thousand dollars. And I said, William, I said, if you can get to New York, you can walk home. And that's what I told him. That was my exact words. And I declare, there are over thousands of people still left in Ghana. And if they could get 1,000 miles from home, they will walk. But the airport is still closed. To God be the glory. Thank you, Pastor. God bless you. God bless you. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. God bless you. All right. Well, let's move it on here. We got Worship and Art, Reverend Pitts. You ready? Where are you? All right, while she's getting ready, I'll just take about a minute and just say thank you, Jesus. Everybody, thank you, Jesus. He knows. He knows. Thank you, Jesus. I just want to thank you, Lord, for bringing us here today. Thank you. Thank you. Hallelujah, thank you.
God is able. God is able, and He won't fail. God is able. God is able. God is able, and He won't fail. Tell me who can make a mountain move out of my way? Who can make a miracle because of my faith? When the doctor says no, who can still say yes? And when I'm in trouble, who's right there to help me? so that the sun can look at me. And who can tell the wind to whistle through the trees? And when I'm in trouble, who's that same God that will come down and rescue me? God is able. God is able. God is able. And God is able. Tell you God is able. And he won't. No, God won't. He won't fail. God won't. He'll never leave, never forsake. No, he won't fail. He'll be there till the end. God won't fail. He won't fail.
Hallelujah. 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 How many know God won't fail? We got any witnesses out there to know that God will never fail us? No matter what comes our way, God is faithful. Hallelujah. Don't clap for me, clap for God. God is faithful. Amen. Give God some praise. He's worthy of it. Amen. Excited to be amongst our First Baptist family one more time. Amen. Our scripture for today is coming from Psalms 111. If you can, stand to your feet for the reading of God's word. You can also turn to Psalm 11 in New King James Version. And it reads, "Praise the Lord. I will praise the Lord with my whole heart in the assembly of the upright and in the congregation. The works of the Lord are great, studied by all who have pleasure in them. His work is honorable and glorious, and his righteousness endures forever. He has made his wonderful works to be remembered. The Lord is gracious and full of compassion. He has given food to those who fear him. He will ever be mindful of his covenant. He has declared to people, his people, excuse me, the power of his works in giving them the heritage of the nation. The works of his hands are verity and justice. All his precepts are sure. They stand fast forever and ever and are done in truth and righteousness. He has sent redemption to his people. He has commanded his covenant forever. Holy and awesome is his name. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom, a good understanding having all those who do his commandment. His praise endures forever." Amen. Thank you.
Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom then shall I fear? Whom then shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom then shall I be afraid? Though a host of men were led against me, yet shall not my heart be afraid. And though there rose a war against me, yet will I put my trust in Him. For in the time of trouble, He shall hide me in His tabernacle. In the secret places of His dwelling shall He hide me. And set me up upon a rock of a son. Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom then shall I fear? Whom then shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. The Lord is the strength of my life. Whom then shall I be afraid? Of whom then shall I be afraid?
Walk together, children, don't you get weary. Walk together, children, don't you get weary. Walk together, children, don't you get weary. There's a great camp meeting in the promised land. Oh, walk together, children, don't you get weary. Walk together, children, don't you get weary. Walk together, children, don't you get weary. There's a great camp meeting in the promised land. Gonna walk and never tire. Oh, walk and never tire. Walk and never tire. can meet in the promised land. Oh, walk together, children, don't you get weary. Walk together, children, don't you get weary. Walk together, children, don't you get weary. There's a great can meet in the promised land. Gonna sing and never tire. Oh, sing and never tire. Sing and never tire. There's a great camp meeting in the promised land. Oh, walk together, children, don't you get weary. Walk together, children, don't you get weary. All together, children, don't you get a weary. There's a great camp meeting in the promised land. Gonna shout and never tire. Oh, shout and never tire. Shout and never tire. There's a great camp meeting in the promised land. Oh, walk together, children, don't you get weary. Sing together, children, don't you get weary. Shout together, children, don't you get weary. There's a great camp meeting, great camp meeting, great camp meeting in the
Again, my brothers and sisters, it's a pure delight to be here this day. Truly, this is the day that the Lord hath made, and we shall rejoice and be glad in it forever. To that end, I want everybody who can stand to stand on your feet and just say, praise the Lord. I mean like you mean it. Just say, praise the Lord. Praise ye the Lord. Praise the Lord. Let everything that hath breath praise ye the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. What a mighty God be served. My brothers and sisters, this is a great day to be alive and to know you're alive. Truly, truly, God has been good to us. You may be seated. God has been good to us from everlasting to everlastings, and his mercies are without an expiration date. He gives 10,000 blessings each day, and oftentimes we're not even aware of it. But to him be the glory for the things he has done and what he is doing and what he will continue to do. This day is a great moment in life and history of this congregation. Yes, some 44 years ago, some 8 souls organized, then known the Mozart Baptist Church, in what was then a stable that they was using from the turn of the century to shoe horses and fix wheels on burgers and wagon. We didn't always have automobiles before the turn of the century. There was wagon and all of that. Even the fire trucks was wagon. My wife's great-grandmother lived with us, and she lived to be 101 years old. And she would never say fire truck because she said fire wagon. Because when she was a little girl, Smith, you're supposed to go around. Don't walk in front of the camera. Go on, you did it. Yes, we want to thank God. We want to thank him for his everlasting love. We just want to thank him because our God is an awesome God. As you celebrate your birthday this day, your birthday, a time to be excited, a time to be thankful. And I thought it would be fitting as we come today with the sermon title, time to reflect with thanks. Yes. I know this year has been a challenge in so many ways. It has affected us in negative ways. Many of us have lost loved ones to the coronavirus, but still we're standing. Some people have some tragedy, have some heartaches and pain and illness, but God is still faithful. And so we need to just pause and say, thank you. God give us so many blessings, and it's fitting that we just don't go through life consumed by what we want and what we think. But I tell you, church, we ought to take time out and praise him. We need to take time out and praise the Lord for his faithfulness, because he's faithful day unto day, night unto night, and to him be the glory. So because of his faithfulness, we have rejoicing in our hearts and thanksgiving and praises upon our lips because of the faithfulness of the Lord. As the song goes, can't nobody do me like Jesus. Not my mama, not my dad. I know they love me, but can't nobody do me like Jesus, because he's a friend and a friend indeed. And he's my number one advocate. Yes, he upholds us by in the palm of his hand. So to God be the glory. Today, as you celebrate your 76 years, it hasn't always been easy as a congregation. Had many struggles and pains. Certainly, in recent years, we can just reflect. In 1974, a late judge, federal judge, in the name of Daniel Cavelli, gave us a 30-day notice and told us to leave this premise and never look back. That's what the judge said. But I declare, we didn't move one step, because God is in charge. Church, God is in charge. And so we have give him the praise and the glory and honor. More recently, in 2011, we had a major storm that swept through Chicago, tore up the balcony and some other stuff, cost over $4 million, pretty close to $4 million in damage. But yet, we're still here. We're still here. You ought to thank the Lord. Yes, yes. Not only does God take care of buildings, but God take care of our families. Many of you have had some dire situations as it relates to your health, as it relates to your finances, as it relates to your relationship with other people. Yes, but God is still here. What a wonderful thing to know that God is your God, because he's able to keep you. Not only is he able to keep you, but he's able to do exceedingly abundantly above anything that you and I can even think of, imagine. We serve a mighty God and an awesome God, and to him be the glory because of his loving kindness and tender mercies that he demonstrates toward us every day. We can truly say, I know in November we celebrate Thanksgiving, but every day, you hear me? Every day is a day of Thanksgiving because of the marvelous things that God has given us, and that he sustained us with this grace and his loving kindness. He is so good. Yes, he's more than words can express. Church, I want you to know today that we serve a mighty God and a tender and everlasting Father. We need to let it be known. We need to rejoice. We need to make a joyful noise unto the Lord. Yes, everything that have breath should praise the Lord. Yes, yeah, the Lord has a way of opening doors. Yeah. We have been missing each other for almost 5 months. Only maybe a dozen of us have been able to come back and render the service on Facebook and conference call. But today, look at you. Look in the parking lot. Yeah, I think we have more than 100 people here today. That's wonderful. That's wonderful. God always make an opportunity. God always make a way out of no way. And to him be glory. Yes, to him be the glory. When this was brought to me earlier, Reverend Williams was talking about having cars in parking lot. I said, no, man, we can't get 40 cars in parking lot. That's not going to work. And so later on, when we had the men's march last Saturday, we had over 200 men in this parking lot. And so we said, yeah, we can do it now. But we can't do it with cars, but we set up the chairs and the tents and the tables, and we would do it. And look at you. Look at you today. Thank you for coming out. I know someone had reservations saying, well, you know, this coronavirus is still out there. But I'll tell you, just do the things that are safe and don't be locked down with fear. Yeah, I know some people have special health needs and you need to be especially cautious, but don't let faith guide your day. Don't let fear guide your day. Let faith guide your day. Let your trust in God lead you and guide you, my brothers and sisters. So today we come to praise the Lord. We come to sing praise to his name. We come to honor him. We come to rejoice in his power. Yes, all of us through the years have been through a lot. But still, we can say, thank you, Jesus. We can thank him. As the song says, when I consider the things and the places I've been, when I consider my bad days, and I've had some bad days and you have too, but when I consider it, but when I think about the goodness of the Lord, when, you know, reflect, church, we need to reflect. Yeah, we had a lot of problems. We had a lot of insurgents in 2020. But still, we cannot abandon the God who we serve because he's in charge. No matter what come, no matter what go, God is still in charge. And so when we stop and take a moment to reflect, and when I think about my bad days, but then when I consider, soberly consider, all my good days, every day outweigh my bad days. Yes, it's a good day just because you're alive. It's a good day because you're enclosed in your right mind. It's a good day because you have the mobility of your body. It's a good day because you can smile. When can you reach your friends? Many of us have not seen each other in 5 months, but look at us today. We're in the open air with smiles on our faces and thanksgiving in our heart and praise upon our lips because we just marvel at the things that God does for us. Hallelujah. Praise his holy name. God is awesome and we need to praise him. Yes, my brothers and sisters, it's better to praise than to panic. Did you hear me? It's better to praise than to panic. But those who don't know the Lord, they have one mode, and that's the panic mode. I tell you, church, we don't have to stand in the panic mode because we got a praise button. Yeah, when that panic come upon you and you don't know what to do, feel like you're overwhelmed, just hit the praise button. And I declare when you hit the praise button, that panic has a way of dissipating and has a way of disappearing. Yes, yes. I want you to understand, my brother, praise is better than having a problem conscious. Yeah, some people, that's all they think about. Well, I don't know what's going to happen to me. I know what happened to my neighbor. So am I next? I just can't get past this thought of being negativity. I just getting thought of feeling like something bad going to happen to me. But I just want you to know, it is better to praise than to panic, because panic exacerbates situations and make them worse. It's better to praise than to be pessimistic. Yeah. Some people say, well, you know, I won't believe it until I see it. And I tell you, my brothers and sisters, we need to look to God, who's the author and the finisher of our faith. Don't just look at CNN and let CNN determine how much comfort you will have, how much peace you will have, because most news that come through the media is bad news. It's bad news. But I come to tell you today, there is good news. Good news in the word of God. Because the good news tells us that God loves us. The good news tells us that God will keep us. The good news tells us that God will sustain us. The good news tells us God will never forsake us. It's just so wonderful to know that we have a God who loves us and cares for us. In fact, the word of God tells us that all of our situations and problems that we cannot handle, cast them on him. That's what the prophet Peter said. Cast your cares upon the Lord, for he knows what you're concerned with. He knows what your cares are. So my brothers and sisters, it's good to know the Lord. For many years, you've heard me say, as your pastor, stand in the pulpit many times, saying, look to God, who is the healer. Look to God, who's the deliverer. But don't look to God through your problems. Look to God around your problems. Look, go straight to God. Don't come with a plethora of excuses and God, why this and why that. But just say, simply, as the sinner said in the gospel, one guy was pietistic for his religious character and behavior. Talking about, God, I thank him not like other men. I tithe, I do this, I visit with us. But this poor man just smote his breast and said, Lord, have mercy on me. Don't you know that's what we have to say sometime? Sometimes we're so burdened, we don't know anything else to say. There are situations when the only thing we say is just Jesus. Jesus understand. He know what you're going through with. Somebody else may not understand, but God knows everything. Why? Because he's omniscient. And so, my brothers, every day, my sisters, every day, we need to continue to count our blessings and name them one by one. In fact, from the text that we read today in Psalm 111:4-5, it says, he has made his wondrous works to be remembered. Don't you remember? Don't you reflect? Don't you know where you come from? Just think about it. You haven't always been in the position you're in today. I mean emotionally, spiritually, socially, financially. Some of us came up on the hard side of the mountain, but God brought us up. We know that when we get here by our strength. Some of us had some paralyzing diseases and doctors gave diagnosis that there was no hope. But when Dr. Jesus came in the room and when Dr. Jesus touched our bodies, we looked up and said, thank you, Jesus. And when God touched us, it defied scientific, it defied medical science, because only God has all power. Yeah. The word of God said, let not your confidence stand in the wisdom of men, but in the power of God. I tell you, our God is an awesome God. And I thank you for doing what he does. Every day he blesses us. Every day he gives us benefits. Every day we ought to praise him and thank him for what he's doing. We thank God for the communities in which we live in. We thank God for our family members. We thank God for the church. We thank God for the church universal. Yes, we want to just thank him and praise him. In fact, the word of God says, let everything that have breath praise the Lord. I mean to tell you, you don't have to have a choir to praise the Lord. You don't have to have a praise team to praise the Lord. You don't have to have a prayer band to praise the Lord. But when you think about his goodness, I mean, I don't care where you are. You may be taking a shower, but when you think about his goodness, you just want to say, thank you, Jesus. You may be sitting at your breakfast table. When you think about his goodness, they put a meal in front of you. You just want to say, thank you, Jesus. It may be late at night, just before you close your eyes. You may be lying in your bed, and you think about, Lord, I got a bed to lie in. There are so many people who don't have a bed. There are so many people who don't have a place to stay. And God, I pray that you make provisions for them. But Lord, in the meantime, I just want to thank you. Lord, I just want to thank for having a bed to lie down in. Lord, I just want to thank for a roof being over my head. Lord, I just want to bless your name. I just want to praise you. I just want to magnify you. I just want to exalt you. I just want to extol you, because Lord, you're an awesome God. You're an everlasting Father. You're the Prince of Peace. You're my joy. You're my salvation. You're my strength. Oh Lord, you're my redeemer. You're my keeper. You're my peacemaker. Oh God, you're my mind regulator. Lord, I wouldn't dare not praise you for all your marvelous benefits. Lord, you thank you. Thank you for grace. Thank you for mercy. Thank you for goodness. Thank you for salvation. Thank you for deliverance. Oh God, I just want to thank you for claiming me as your child. Lord, I know I'm not worthy, but thank you, twin powers of grace and mercy. Lord, you saw me in the sea of sin, sinking to rise no more. But the master of the sea reached down in the sins, picked me up from my despairing cry. Yes, yes, he's awesome. Church, we need to magnify him. We need to praise him. We need to glorify him. Every day of our lives, we need to tell somebody, I know Jesus. He's my Lord. He's my Savior. He's my keeper. He's my friend. He's my joy. He's my strength. And I'm going to run on and see what the end going to be. I know there will be some obstacles in the future, but still I'm going to run. I'm going to run with the star post in glory in front of me. I'm going to run with faith. I'm going to run under grace. I'm going to have the banner of grace in front of me. And so I'm going to run. When I see obstacles, I'm not going to be distracted. I'm not going to stop praising him. That's going to cause me to praise him even the more. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord. Just praise him, church. Just tell him, thank you, Lord. Thank you for waking me up this morning. Thank you for being in close of my right mind. Thank you, Lord. I just want to thank you that I had a desire to fellowship. What a mighty God we serve. What an awesome God. He's from everlasting to everlasting. His benefits never run out. I know some of us are concerned about the stimulus stuff, and we do need that. But I declare the benefits of the Lord are not regulated by man, but his benefits are 10,000 times 10,000, and they flow constantly. There's not a second, there's not a moment that God does not dismiss his benefits on his children. Because he dispenses benefit, we all just say, thank you, thank you, thank you. Hallelujah, thank you. Hallelujah. Thank the Lord. Lord Jesus. Lord. Lord. We just want to take time to reflect with thankfulness. Lord, forgive us of those times, Lord, where we complain more than we praise you. Lord, help us overcome those moments. Lord, we love you. We praise you. And we honor you. So thanks be to God. Thanks be to God. At this time, we're going to have invitation. But Reverend Jones, if you could, today is second Sunday. We haven't had a healing service in over 5 months. So if you could go up in the sanctuary and bring the anointing oil down, we would do that. But in the meantime, I'm going to ask someone to come. Reverend Cliff, you behind me? I thank you down to do the invitation. So you come on, do the invitation, then have someone to come up and do the healing prayer.
Perhaps, maybe, it could be someone that in the midst of my hearing voice that don't know Jesus Christ in the pardon of their sins. There could be maybe someone that's in a backslidden condition like I once was. Or there could be someone looking for a church home. After that powerful message, after hearing from the Word of God, I would invite you to come to Jesus Christ. I would invite you not to put it off for tomorrow, what you should do today. Would you come to Jesus? Come as you are. Say this for a word of encouragement. It's best to have him and not need him, and to need him and not have him. Time is running out. So you know your spiritual thermometer. If you're on the sideline, if you know you need to get it right, would you wave your hand if you're sitting in the car or wherever you're at? If you know you need to come to him, it needs to be now, now. Is that one? To God be the glory.
Those of you that want healing, or you want to sit in for someone, we ask you to take these front seats, please. Let's pray. Father, thank you, because we know there's nothing too hard for you. You can do whatever needs to be done, however it needs to be done. But we come right now especially for healing. Father, you've healed us even before we know we needed it. But there are some things we know that we need your touch. So Father, we pray in Jesus' name now that you would move and touch by your Spirit our bodies, our minds, our souls, our families. Thank you, Lord. Some of us are troubled, we're worried, we're bothered. But fix that, Lord, in Jesus' name. And we thank you. Help us to know by faith that you can do and will do whatever needs to be done. Thank you, Lord. We don't have to tell you how. You already know how. Thank you, Jesus. Because you are Jehovah Rapha, the one that heals, corrects, fixes, straightens out, makes peace in our mind. Thank you, Jesus. When the world is going upside down, when people are worried, we don't have to, because we trust in you. Thank you, Jesus. So we pray now and thank you now for what you have already done and what you're going to do still. Thank you for the ones that you've recovered from COVID. Thank you for the ones that you're going to help recover from COVID. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus, because there's nobody like you. We praise you. We bless you. We magnify your name for your healing and for your grace and for your mercies. Father, we do thank you. We do thank you. We do praise you as we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you.
that Jesus is the strength of our joy. Thank you, Father, for your loving kindness and your tender mercies. Lord, we just want to bless you and praise you for your favor and your faithfulness. To God be the glory for all that he has done, all that he's doing, and all that he's going to do. With thanksgiving and praises, we say thank you, Father. Thank you. Now let us receive the benediction. I know it. Let us receive the benediction. Most holy and gracious Father, Lord, we thank you for this day that you've given us. Now to him who's able to do exceedingly abundantly above all that we may ask or think, according to the power of the work within us, unto him be glory in the church by Christ Jesus, throughout all ages, world without end. Amen. You may end the recording.